Hi, welcome back to another episode of the Guys Book Club in the Most Weekend Book Club. And today, guys, we're on an extremely special episode. Because today, guys, we're on episode 192. Ding! Can you believe it, guys? We already achieved 192 episodes, which is blowing my mind. Like, damn, it's a huge achievement. And what it means that we only have 8 episodes left until we reach the 200 episodes special. So let's go. So hi guys, and everyone, welcome to everyone. If you're new to the channel, welcome, and if you're already familiar with the channel, welcome back. My name is Zeke, and I'm host. And on this podcast, guys, my goal from this podcast is to inspire other people to speak in English and to get used to send from the camera. I'm doing so because I truly believe that English is the number one tool that each one of us must acquire in order to be successful in life. And the second tool that is going to help us a lot is to know how to get better from the camera. And guys, if you take those two and to combine those both two, if you combine both skills together, you can create great content in English for social media, and you can communicate with billions of people around the world. So the problem is that there are a lot of people want to do it, but they're afraid. I don't know, they have a lack of confidence to speak in English, talking on the camera. And there I am trying to inspire other people to do the same, to work on the English and to speak in English and to make kind of content in front of the camera. And how I do it by self-example, by coming only 5 episodes per week, recording myself, 5 episodes per week, appearing on the camera, sharing my message with you guys, and hopefully inspiring you guys. So if you like it, enjoy it. You guys will see, I get this great background behind me. And this guy over there, you know, he said, "Hey, I must come to the podcast," and it's on his way. The podcast, if you can see me, I'm over here. Right now, I'm podcasting from this house. Yeah, it's real. You can, I thought we say it's fake, but you believe in AK, you trust. Huh? It's real, I tell you guys. And if you want to check out this great background, you know, you can find it on free too. You can find it in good fun. In this great background, I upload to Good Fun by Keepish One on 8th of December 2018. And of course, guys, we leave a thumb up because we really love the podcast. We really love this great background. And if you want to download it, you just need to choose the resolution. Click on it, and then you can choose the resolution. After that, press download. Right click, Shmirat Moed Moshem, enable or set pictureless. Choose when you want to choose it. When you want to save it, press save and come back just like that. You got this great background on your computer. So thank you very much, Keepish One, and thank you very much to the artist who made this great background. And today, guys, we'll continue habit number 5. Look to understand before being understood. From the 7 habits of highly effective people, great book, I recommend. Guys, if you want to check out this great background, or if you want to check out Stephen or Covey or the book, you got the link here in the description below. Another thing, guys. If you enjoy the podcast, if you learn something new from the podcast, please let me know in the comment below if you learned something new or if you have any suggestion for me. I can improve myself or the podcast, please let me know in the comment below. And if anyone of you guys want to come and be a guest on the podcast, please let me know also so we can arrange it and so you can share your message with the world. And guys, if you can help me, please like the video, subscribe to the channel, share it for friends, family, and friends, and put the notification bell so you'll be notified each time. It's extremely exciting episode, disclaimer, every episode is extremely exciting episode, so you will get 5 extremely exciting episodes per week. You will be notified when it's coming to YouTube, so just do it right now, let's pause, so you can do it. And back to the video, let's go. Guys, without any more introduction, I just dive right into the book. So the 7 habits of highly effective people, page 241, by Stephen Covey, made by the myth, the legend, the man, you know, the man himself, 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 the man him your boy, hey, yeah, 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 what's up, Zed, what's up, Zed, what's up, Zed, what's up, that's me, so let's go, let's go, let's go. Making content is easy. Just listen to the words that come out of someone's mouth and you repeat them. You're hardly even using your brain at all. Boy, 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 dead. I have had it. School is for the beans. You have had it. You finish school is for the beans. You have essentially repeated back the content of what was being said. You haven't evaluated or probed or advised or interpreted. You have at least showed you are paying attention to his work. But to understand, you want to be do more. You want to do more. The second stage of empathic listening is to repress the content. It's a little more effective, but it's still limited to the verbal communication. Boy, Dad, I've done it. I read it. School is for the beans. You don't want to go to school anymore. This time, you have put his meaning into your own words. Now you are thinking about what he said, mostly with the left side, the reasoning and logical side of the brain. The first stage brings your right brain into operation. You reflect feeling. Boy, Dad, I read it. School is for the beans. You are feeling really frustrated. Now you are not paying as much attention to what he's saying as you are to the way he feels about what he's saying. The fourth stage includes both the second and the film. You repress the content and then reflect the feeling. Boy, Dad, I read it. School is for the beans. You are really frustrated about school. Frustration is a feeling. School is a content. You are using both sides of your brain to understand both sides of his communication. Now, what happens when you see fourth stage of empathic? Now, what happens when you use a fourth stage empathic listening skills in his listening skills is really incredible. You see, you are authentically sick to understand. As you repress content and reflect feeling, you give his psychological error. You give him psychological error. You also help him walk through his own thoughts and feelings. As he grows in his confidence of your sincere desire to really listen and understand, the barrier between what is going on inside him and what is actually being communicated to you disappears. It opens a soul-to-soul flow. He's not thinking and feeling one thing and communicating another. He begins to trust you with his innermost tender feelings and thoughts. Boy, Dad, I have it. School is for the beans. I want to talk with you to get your attention. You're really fascinated about school. That's right. That is how I feel. I sure am. It's totally impractical. I'm not getting a feeling out of it. You feel like school's not doing you any good. Let me think. Is that what I mean? Well, yeah. I'm just not learning anything that is going to help me. I mean, look at Joe. He's dropped out of school and he's working on cars. He's making money. Now that is practical. You feel that Joe already has the right idea. Well, I guess he does in a way. He's really making money now. But in a few years, I bet he will probably be ticked off at himself. He thinks Joe is going to feel he made the wrong decision. He's got it. If somebody's going to talk to me like this, what do you want from me? It's annoying. Just look at what he is giving up. I mean, if you don't have an education, you just can't make it in this world. Education is really important. Oh, yeah. I mean, if you don't have a diploma, if you can't get jobs or go to college, what are you going to do? You have just got to get an education. It's true, you need to get an education, but in this world, you don't need to get a degree. Elon Musk said, you can learn anything from the internet, and Tesla and a lot of companies, they are not requesting any more degrees, but they are looking for your resume, see your knowledge. It's important to your future. It is. And you know what? I'm really going. Listen, you won't tell mom, will you? You don't want your mother. You don't want your mother to find out. Well, not really. Oh, not really. Oh, I guess you can tell her. She will probably find out anyway. Look, I took this test today. This learning test, and then they said I'm learning on a fourth grade level. Fourth grade, and I'm in junior high school. What a difference strain understanding can make. What is a very meaning advice in the world won't amount to a idea of beans if we are not even addressing the real problem? And we will never get to the problem if we are so caught up in our own autobiography, our own paradigms, that we don't take off our glasses long enough to see the world from another point of view. I'm going to flunk that. I guess if I'm going to flunk, I might as well quit. But I don't want to quit. If you turn, you are in the middle of a diploma, of a dilemma. What do you think I should do then? By seeking first to understand, this father has just turned a transactional opportunity into a transformational opportunity. Instead of interacting on a surface, get the job done and level of communication, he has created a situation in which he can now have a transforming impact, not only on his son, but also on the relationship. By setting aside his own autobiography and really seeking to understand, he has made a tremendous deposit in the emotional bank account and has empowered his son to open layer upon layer and to get to the real issue. Now father and the son are on the same side of the table looking at the problem, instead of on opposite sides, looking across at each other. The son is opening his father's autobiography and asking for advice. Even as the father begins to counsel, however, he needs to be sensitive to his son's communication. As long as the response is logical, the father can effectively ask questions and give counsel. But the moment the response becomes emotional, he needs to go back to empathetic listening. Well, I can see some things you might want to consider. Like what, Ed? Like getting some special help with your reading. Maybe they have some kind of a tutoring program over at the tech school. I've already checked into that. It takes two nights and all day Saturday. That will take so much time. Sensing emotion in that reply, the father moves back to empathy. That is too much of a price to pay. Besides that, I told the sixth graders I would be the coach. You don't want to let them down. But I will tell you this, Dad. If I really thought that a tutoring course would end, I would be down there every night. I would get someone else to coach those kids. You really want the help, but you doubt if the course will make a difference? Do you think it would, Dad? It's our top award. And I don't think it's a conversation about this way. The son is once more open and logical. He is opening his father's autobiography again. Now the father has another opportunity to influence and transform. There are times when transformation requires no outside consult. Often when people are really given the chance to open up, they reveal their own problems and the solutions that become clear to them in the process. At other times, they really need additional perspective and help. The key is to genuinely seek the welfare of the individual, to listen with empathy, to let the person get to the problem and the solution at his own pace and time. Layer upon layer, It's like peeling an onion until you get to the soft inner core. When people are really hurting, and you really listen with when people are really hurting, and you really listen with a pure desire to understand, you will be amazed how fast they will open up. They want to open up. Children desperately want to open up, even more to their parents than to their peers. And then to their peers. And they will, if they feel their parents will love them unconditionally and will be faithful to them afterwards, and they're not judged or really call them. If you really seek to understand without hypocrisy and without guilt, there will be times when you will be literally stunned with the pure knowledge and understanding that will flow to you from another human being. It isn't even always necessary to talk in order to emphasize. In fact, sometimes words may just get in your way. That is one very important reason why technique alone will not work. That kind of understanding transcends technique. Isolated technique only gets in the way. I have gone through the skills of empathetic listening because skill is an important part of any habit. We need to have the skills. But let me reiterate that the skill will not be effective unless they come from a sincere desire to understand. People resent any attempt to manipulate them. In fact, if you are dealing with people you are close to, it's helpful to tell them what you are doing. I read this book about listening and empathy, and I thought about my relationship with you. I realized I haven't listened to you like I should, but I want to. It's hard for me. I might blow it up at times, but I'm going to work at it. I really care about you, and I want to understand. I hope you will help me. Affirming your motive is a huge deposit. But if you are not sincere, I wouldn't even try it. It might create an openness and a vulnerability that will later turn to your arm when a person discovers that you really didn't care. You really didn't want to listen, and he is left open, exposed, and don't. The technique is the tip of the iceberg. Has to come out of the massive base of character underneath. Now there are people who protest that empathetic listening takes too much time. It might take a little more time initially, but it saves so much time downstream. The most efficient thing you can do if you are a doctor and want to prescribe a wise treatment is to make an accurate diagnosis. You can't say, I'm too much of a worry. I don't have time to make a diagnosis. Just take this treatment. I remember writing one time in a room. I remember writing one time in a room on the north shore of Hawaii. There was a soft breeze blowing, and so I had opened the two windows. One is the front and one is the side, to keep the room cool. And a number of papers laid out, chapter by chapter, on a large table. Suddenly, the breeze stands. There is a centerpiece in Israel, and he said, suddenly, Shachar Hassan is ready. Suddenly, the breeze started picking up and blowing my papers out. I remember the frightening sense of loss I felt because things were no longer in order. Including a number of pages. And I began rushing around the room, trying desperately to put them back. Finally, I realized it would be better to take 10 seconds and close one of the windows. And saying that, we are now closing the episode. So thank you for joining me. I really appreciate you to see this on me. And now that's your turn. I did my job. I did my personal example, and now it's your turn. Go out and start the board, make a difference in Bulgaria because you are in vocal English, start the board. And be a safe example of genius, and I don't know what you are trying to achieve in life, but be a safe
By the way,
set an example of it. So guys, I really enjoyed the episode and I hope that you enjoy it too. And I really hope to see you tomorrow, guys. Hope to see you guys tomorrow on an extremely exciting episode. Extremely exciting episode. Episode number 183. Until then, guys, have a great time. Take care for yourself and peace. Bye-bye. So guys, the day today is Thursday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. It's Tuesday, 14th of September, 2021, and time now it's 11:48. התאריך היום יום שלישי, 14 עד שיפן, שמחת השעה עכשיו 11:48 בערב, אז אחרי יום עבודה, באתי, לא התעצלתי, ונתתי בראש, עשיתי עוד פודקאסט, ועכשיו אני הולך רק נעבור את זה בטמק הפסט, סייר מני, סאבס כמו בייב. Right now it's episode 100. Let's see. Episode 183. And we have one subscriber. Yeah, shout out to my customer to the one subscriber. And we just we got a let's Thank you very much. It's episode 183. So, this episode, we have 10 episodes, we are 9 episodes in advance, so it's good. And we have 146 views of the channel. Let's see some analytics. By the way, tomorrow I need to upload all of the results of the episode because this is the episode of today, the time is today, and yeah, you need to continue. Analytics. We have 32 episode views on the previous 28 days. Exposure, we have been reached. Damn! We achieve 110% more exposures. 2,000, yeah, it's good. 2,000 watch time, 200 exposures, which means 2,000 people saw my pretty face. 21 unique views. The watch for 27 seconds. Audience, don't see. And let's see from. Here we had 157 views, 11,500 my pretty face, people see my friend saw my pretty face. The average duration of time is 3 minutes, including all the times that I watch my own videos. And that's what's up. I don't know how much of any comeback views. Yeah, it's up, and let's go, yalla. B'chem kippur, shel b'chava tzicha l'kulan, utzom kal, b'gmar k'chad ma tova, yom shal esh nirayim b'ariyel, l'nitzig m'robot chavrati, to m'nayel taim, shel b'chava tzicha, bye.